Welcome back. Remember that the goal for dimensionality reduction is to find a lower dimensional subspace that you can use to capture much of the structure of your original data. So to understand how this can work, we need to understand how you can represent data in multiple different coordinate systems. In fact, there are many ways to represent multivariate data. We can define a basis as a set of n vectors that you can use to construct any point in an n-dimensional vector space. We're used to using a specific choice of basis called the standard basis, in which your first basis vector is one unit in the direction of the activity for neuron one, and the second basis vector is one unit in the direction of neuron two. So when we say that this point here is equal to 3, 2, what that really means is that we can represent it as a combination of 3 times the vector u plus 2 times the vector w. But this is not the only basis that we could imagine for this data. So you could rotate these basis vectors and therefore represent this point v as a completely different set of coefficients. So in this case, your v would be 3.5 times the vector u minus 1.2 times the vector w. These are both examples of orthogonal bases. So in both the standard basis and this rotated basis, all of the basis vectors are orthogonal to each other. You can also have a basis where the vectors are not orthogonal. So here's an example of that, but you can still represent each point in the two-dimensional plane as a combination of these two vectors. You can also rescale your bases. So in this case, I'm rescaling the standard basis by increasing u and w so that v is now equal to 1, 1 instead of 3, 2. This is an example where the basis vectors are orthogonal, but it's not an orthonormal basis. By orthonormal, we mean that the basis is orthogonal and all basis vectors have a length of 1, and we can measure the length as the square root of the sum of the squared values of the entries. It's worth noting that if you already have an orthogonal basis, then you can very easily normalize it by dividing each basis vector by its magnitude. So now the question is, how do you tell if your two basis vectors are orthogonal to each other? So you can test this using the dot product, which is a scalar quantity, so it's just a number, and it's a function of two vectors. So u dot w is defined as the magnitude of u times the magnitude of w times the cosine of the angle between them. And what happens if it is at a right angle? So if they're perpendicular or orthogonal, then the cosine is equal to 0. So that means that the dot product is 0. And in fact, two vectors are defined as orthogonal exactly when the dot product is equal to 0. But does this mean that we need to always look for the angle between any two vectors to find out if they're orthogonal? Thankfully, there is another formulation of the dot product. So this is the algebraic definition, and it turns out that these are actually equivalent definitions if you use some trigonometric identities to prove it. So u dot w can also write as the sum of ui times wi. That's much easier to calculate, especially in a vector format. So if u and w are both column vectors, then u dot w is u transpose times w. So this is a much easier way to test if two vectors are orthogonal, is by taking u transpose times w.